Hello, this is Sarah Brosh. Welcome or welcome back to my channel. So I want to do a video about how the Karen, the use of the term Karen as part of the Karen memes, the Karen's Gone Wild videos, is absolutely a racial slur. It is not at all benign. It is not at all benign. And this goes hand in hand with my criticisms of trial by Twitter in general, but I specifically want to focus on the use of the term Karen. And this recently, and there's a very specific reason why this is not at all benign, and the people using it know that it's not at all benign. They know that it's a racial slur. They know that they are attempting to demonize white women when they use the term Karen. They know that there are potentially very dangerous consequences to the use of the term Karen as part and parcel of their efforts to destroy the Living While Black movement by turning it into a blood sport, targeting in particular vulnerable white women with obvious or ostensible mental health disabilities, and targeting them as collective punishment against white women for Trump's election. That's what's happening. That's what's happening. That's what happened to me when the Living or Napping While Black hate crime hoax at Yale was propagated around the world, and the video that Lalata Siambola took was propagated around the world. And this was very, very obviously a video that was meant to publicly shame me for my mental health disabilities. And it was very obvious from the video that she took on May 8th, 2018, that she meant to target me for my mental health disabilities, publicly shame me for my mental health disabilities. And it was perfectly obvious that the video was the grossest violation of my privacy. I did not consent to being filmed or recorded, and I was not aware that I was being filmed or recorded, and I was standing in the threshold of my own isolated Yale dorm room in the middle of the night. But anyway, so I want to specifically focus on the use of the term Karen as a racial slur. This is what my PhD dissertation is largely about. It's a dissertation on the philosophical foundations of law and language, and I look at linguistic meanings of terms as social institutions and how those social institutions arise in a population, evolve, devolve, and eventually collapse, and also how quasi-rational individual agents intentionally pressure the evolution and devolution of their social groups, social institutions, including the linguistic meanings of terms, including a term like Karen. So people like Karen Attia with the Washington Post, NPR, N.K. Jemisin, the fantasy and sci-fi writer, when these people use Karen to demonize white women, to disparage white women, almost always part and parcel with, hand in hand with the Karen's Gone Wild videos, then targeting private citizen nobodies, usually vulnerable white women, usually with ostensible mental health disabilities, they absolutely know that they are advocating to turn that term Karen into a racial slur, and they are using it as a dog whistle. And this is a very typical way that a subsocial group will advocate to turn a term into a racial slur, is that they are at one and the same time, you know, the Karen has a very specific meaning, linguistic meaning as a racial slur for the subsocial group, and then of woke intersectional feminists, and then for the larger social group, they pretend like it's benign. Oh, it's just playful mockery. It's just playful mockery of the archetype of a middle-aged, upper-middle-class white woman who demands to speak to the manager and is very entitled. It's just playful mockery. It's just playful mockery. Well, it's not playful mockery when, which is what usually occurs, the person using the Karen term, exploiting the Karen meme to demonize and disparage white women, when they almost always couple it with bringing up Emmett Till's murder, the lynching of Emmett Till, who, you know, was murdered after he allegedly whistled at a white woman, Caroline Bryant, I believe is her name. And anyway, so when you bring this up, and you bring this up, and you also equate 911 calls by white women, even of dubious or ambiguous motivation, when you equate 911 calls with modern day lynchings, when you say that Karens use their iPhones as weapons to call 911, and that is a modern day lynching or attempted lynching, and you bring up Emmett Till's murder in the same breath, in the same article, in the same paragraph, then you know that you are using the Karen term to demonize white women. You know that you are trying to turn it into a racial slur. You know that you are exploiting the Karen meme to demonize and disparage white women, to turn, destroy the living while black women by turning it into a blood sport, targeting white women as collective punishment against white women for Trump. And recently, Karen Attia with the Washington Post and M.K. Jemisin, the sci-fi fiction writer, both of whom participated in the global vilification and defamation campaign against me that almost got me killed. Both of them tweeted recently more or less that it's cool to kill white women now. So if you're tweeting that it's cool to kill white women now, don't pretend like use of the term Karen is not a racial slur. Don't pretend like use of the term Karen is benign. You know it's not benign. You know it's not benign. You know exactly what you're doing. You know exactly what you're doing. Yeah. And also NPR did the same thing. NPR recently had a whole article about the Karen meme, defamed me as a genocidal villain who lynches black students at Yale, brought up Emmett Till's murder, equated 911 calls. I never actually called 911, but equates 911 calls by white women to modern day lynchings or attempted lynchings. And then they try to pretend like, well, the Karen meme is benign. That's just playful mockery. That's just playful mockery. And I addressed this in my LetterWiki conversation with Gretchen Mullen with Skeptic Review 89. And I talked about John McWhorter, the Columbia linguistics professor. And I think he's awesome and I adore him. And he has been at the forefront of denouncing cancel culture and denouncing woke intersectional feminism as something of a religious cult, which I agree with. But he also was someone who said that he thought that the Karen meme was, you know, just playful mockery. And I just was so surprised that he said that. And I would love to ask him about that. I would love to talk to him about that, because I was so surprised that he said that, because it very clearly is not. It is not playful mockery when you are bringing up Emmett Till's murder. It's not playful mockery. It's not. And this has really dangerous consequences, and this is something that Gretchen and I talk about in our LetterWiki convo, that it's radicalization. And it's normalizing the demonization of white women. And it's, that's why N.K. Jemisin and Karen Attia of the Washington Post think it's cool, think it's completely okay to more or less tweet that it's cool to kill white women now. And this is really dangerous, and it's really has dangerous consequences. I'm still more or less in hiding. After more than 2 years, I still get deluged by death and rape threats. I'm still intermittently suicidal. So this has really dangerous consequences. It has really dangerous consequences. And when you defame someone in the New York Times and the Washington Post and the LA Times, etc., as a genocidal villain who tries to lynch black students at Yale, you are trying to get that person killed. You're trying to drive that person to suicide. You're trying to incite that person's murder. And there people have already killed themselves. People have already killed themselves, committed suicide. That UNC, University of North Carolina, Wilmington professor who was ousted because of his allegedly, you know, racist and sexist tweets and writings, he just turned up dead. He's dead. I don't think they've officially ruled it a suicide, but they found him dead. So, you know, this is serious. This has serious consequences. And I want to make very clear that I am, every time someone tries to say that the Karen meme is just playful mockery, it's no big deal, you know, it's deserved mockery, then, you know, I'm going to call that out and call a spade a spade. And it is a racial slur, and it's being used to demonize white women as collective punishment against white women for Trump. And there are potentially very dangerous consequences to this. And I am proof positive of that. Look at what was done to me. And so it is not okay when NPR exploits the Karen meme to defame me as a genocidal villain who lynches black students at Yale. It is not okay. It is not okay for Karen Attia to try to drive me to suicide on Twitter. It is not okay for NK Jemisin to try to drive me to suicide on Twitter, to call for me to be disbarred, expelled, prosecuted, arrested, imprisoned. This is not okay. It's not okay. All right. I think I'll stop there, but I love you all so much. Thank you so much for all of your kind words and support, and they mean everything to me. And we are going to stop the moral outrage industry from getting one more innocent person killed. I'll have my PayPal, me, and GoFundMe links below. Please donate to my legal fund so I can start suing some of these people, so I can sue the NPR, so that I can sue the New York Times, so that I can sue CNN, so I can sue Washington Post. We have to stop the moral outrage industry. We have to restore due process and civil liberties at Yale and everywhere. All right, I'll talk to you later.